Hello everyone. So this section we are going to discuss about the numbers multiplication less than the base and other number is more than the base. So let's start with the example. We want to multiply 117, that is 117, and 98. So in the Vedic mathematics way, what we do is we found that this is plus 17 and this is minus 2. In this case, we are taking the base as 100. So let's check out how the things works in the formula. So we can write 117 as 100 plus 17 into 98 as 100 minus 2. So the solution goes like this, which becomes 100, which is our x, whole into next again x plus a, that is 100 plus a is 17 and b is 2 minus b minus a into b, which is 34. So here you can see that 17 is our a and 2 is b. After that, here we get 100 whole into 100 plus 17 minus 2 is 115 minus 34, which is like 115 00 minus 34. So here we do a simple subtraction by taking 10 as borrowing 10 to the end. So our answer comes 114 66. That's all, is a simple way of solving it. So I think it will be very clear to people that why we are taking when we take 34 on the right side, why we take transpose and reduce 1 from the previous number. All those things will be clear. I will just give it again so that if we have any doubt, we'll come to know. So 17 into 2, that gives me 34. I keep 34 here. Then I do 117 minus 2 or 98 plus 17, whatever we do, the answer is 115. I will demonstrate that again. Here either 100 plus 17, if you take, it becomes 117 minus 2, so it becomes 115. Or we can do actually 100 minus 2, which is 98, and plus 17. So that is how this cross addition or cross subtraction works. So after getting 115 34, if you remember, in the normal method, what we do is we take how much less 34 is than 100. So that means we say that 34 is 66 less than 100, and we do minus 1 from this side, which gives me 114, and we get answer as 114 66. So why we do this 34 transpose to find out 66 and do a minus 1 here? The answer is this: because we have 00 at the end, it is exactly something like subtracting 34 from 500. So we take we borrow 10 here till the end. So 10 minus 4 gives me 6. Here it is 9. 9 minus 3 gives me 6. And since we have borrowed 1, so this becomes 4. So 11466. So that is how this principle works. So we'll be discussing a few more special cases and some amazing special cases also, you can say, in the next lecture. Thank you.